Hello, Michael Zalapsky here, and I've got some fun in Trapcode Particular for you today. John Birmingham on Instagram was asking if it would be possible to recreate this sort of look in Trapcode Particular. John Birmingham on Birmingham. Is that how you spell Birmingham? Anyway, the answer is yes to the particles anyway. A couple different ways, actually. Let's go! All right, here we are in After Effects, and all I've got here is Trapcode Particular at complete default settings, except that I have animated a little motion path here. You can do that a number of different ways. Just kind of scribbled around a little bit and got this. Let's hop into the designer and kind of get the base look for this. Unfortunately, you don't get animation of the particular node on the designer because it doesn't have access to After Effects keyframe information, but you can drag it around and kind of get an idea of what it's going to look like. We're going to change the emitter to a sphere emitter, but not a giant one like that, maybe about 100 or so. I'm going to change the particles per second up quite a bit. And I don't think I really need, frankly, any velocity on here for any of this. I'm going to turn it down to zero. Particle type, we don't need any feathering on this. We'll be adding glows and stuff and get the feathering from that. The life, let's make it about, I don't know, probably only about 1.5 seconds long. And we'll give it quite a good bit of randomness, I think. Maybe like 30 or so. And that way, when we have the trail, it just kind of doesn't all die off kind of in one swoop. It just kind of trails off like that. Speaking of how it looks, we definitely need some color over life. And let's go with this nice kind of rainbowy preset. It's actually pretty close to the reference. I think I want a little more purple here in the middle. So I'll grab some extra purple there. Now, you could also go into RGB or lab or any of these other gradient interpolation settings, but I'm using HSV for this one because I like the vibrant transitions between the tones that you get. Maybe a little bit more green because we're definitely going to want to be fading these out. I'm going to use this handy preset, offset slope. Yep, definitely need to move the green earlier. Try there and kind of scooch all these down some. Try that, see how that looks. Yeah, that's pretty good. Our size, we can probably make these smaller with some randomness. Yeah. All right, I'm gonna hit apply. I think this will be a good base, kind of overall. You know what, actually, I'm going to change the emitter behavior from continuous to from emitter speed. This changes it from the particles per second being an exact number to being a multiplier on top of how the speed of the emitter. So if we hit play now, you'll see that it has the fewer particles where it's moving slower and more particles where it's moving fast. So I'm going to actually duplicate this comp. I'll call one of them fluid. And one of them I will call Turbulence. And I use the same particle animation and the same basic colors for both the versions. Let's start with the Turbulence. Let's go further in here. I think we'll go into Environment, Air Turbulence, and the Turbulence controls here. First of all, we definitely need to affect the position, maybe up to 200 or so. Getting some nice fluidy motion looking there. I think we want it to be happening a little sooner. And I think we'll have that happening sooner. So a good way to do that is to just turn the air density up to maybe like 10. That makes all these air turbulence settings just be a lot more extreme. So maybe I'll try 8. Effect position might be a little strong on it. Maybe 150. Yeah, that's a little better. I'm gonna change the scale of it so it's not so small. The higher this number goes, the more detail there appears to be in the noise. The lower scale number makes the shapes that the noise makes look larger. Slightly counterintuitive, but there you go. And I think I'm gonna make the evolution speed significantly higher. So we get a little bit more kind of motion going on. Let's just see how this looks. Yeah, so there you go. That's kind of the basics of that, how that motion goes. Might have that evolution speed a little high. Let me put that on 150 and see how we like the look of that instead. That's looking pretty good. I feel like this is really calling out for, well, number one, more particles. And probably at a slightly smaller size as well. Let's go to our particles, size is 3. Let's make that 2 with maybe some less randomness on the size as well. Maybe 2 with 20. And we'll do more particles per second. We'll do like 10,000. Might want to knock the opacity of the particles down a bit, or you know what, just do whatever you want to go with your look. I want to add some nice glow to our scene. So I'm going to actually apply a solid composite first. Solid composite fills the alpha of your layer. If you see, turn the transparency on, turn solid composite off. You'll see it's particular renders on alpha. Turning solid composite on and turning it to black means that there's no alpha here at all. It's all just color information. And that's going to make optical glow work a little bit better for the look that I want. Turn the size up to 300 or so. And the amount down to maybe, well here, I'll leave the amount up just for a second to show you what happens if I have a solid composite off. It really punches up the visibility of these particles back here, and I don't really want that because it's working on the RGB information. So if I make it dark by adding solid composite in there, it gives me a more realistic look for what I'm after. And I'll put the amount down to 5. And obviously Renoiser, and we'll set that to maybe 16 millimeter. And we'll get in real close. You can kind of see the delicious film grain that gets added here. Maybe we'll do the classic 35. Renoiser takes your image and actually rebuilds it out of film grain. It's really quite handy. I should do a tutorial on it sometime. Modern 35. There we go. Modern 35 just gives us a nice texture here in the glow and helps prevent banding when you upload it to the web. You'll want to turn on motion blur, and that will really complete the look, as it really helps smooth those particles together, makes it feel great. All right, let's work on our fluids. Let's hop into the designer. We will go to our simulations tab and we'll say, hey, enable fluid motion. And you'll see we've got maybe a little bit of something going on. We will make we'll add a vortex ring. That should get you some movement already. There you go, some nice fluid stuff. Let's get some random swirl going on here. We'll do 80, and we'll change this scale to maybe 50. And then we get some even more fluidy stuff. We got some fluid motion going. Let's make this region size a little bigger, but we will make our vortex core size a little smaller. You know what? I think we'll turn the vortex strength down as well. And we'll turn this on to opacity. And we'll turn the viscosity up to maybe 30. And we'll turn our fidelity all the way up. And we'll just hit apply. Now, you'll see we've got some fluidy movement happening here in our little particles here. Take a look. It's not very exciting. But it's got a little bit of motion. The key is that we need to inject a lot more velocity into the simulation for these particles to move around. Now, cranking up the vortex ring, you might think would do it, but that's not how we're going to get it. We're actually going to bump up the velocity from the emitter motion, and we're going to turn this up to maybe 500, so significantly more. And boom! All of a sudden, you see we've got a lot more fluid behavior out of our particles. That's a much more like what we're looking to have. Now let's crank up our particles per second. We'll do maybe 10,000. And we'll see how that looks. Well, that's looking pretty good at 10,000 particles per second, but I'm also gonna change, I'm gonna change this direction to outward on the particles, and I'm gonna give them a velocity of 3,000. And that will inject even more velocity into our sim. I'm going to change the emitter size here to 200. And we'll see how that looks. Nice. I think I'm going to mess with the vortex strength a little bit. So perhaps a little too high. See if I like the look that gives better. There we go. There's another way to get some good fluidy particle motion going on. You might want to make the particles scale up real quick at the beginning so they don't look quite so sparkly there. Let's see, we'll set the size over life to be very quickly going up, like very quickly. And of course, we will want to enable motion blur. And we'll do our other trick that we did earlier. This time we're going to do it right to this layer. Solid composite, all black. Then we will do optical glow. Nice and large, maybe 400. And you know what? Maybe we'll turn the highlight roll off up some. But the amount still down, maybe like, let's do 10. And we will also apply Renoiser. And for Renoiser here, let's zoom in, have a nice look at our noise. We will do Hadley's Hope. So there you go, that's how that one looks. Pretty nice fluidy motion, pretty vibrant colors, looking pretty good. And if you want to make it look even more smooth and more fluidy, you can have even more particles. This is with the particles per second turned up to 100,000 and the opacity down to 20%. Now there's a very lovely video from Zach over at CG Visuals VFX that shows you how to get some gorgeous airbending effects using a similar technique. He's also got some pretty cool fire and earth and water effects, so check those out too. And make sure you follow us here and hit that bell to be notified, because next week probably we'll be doing a tutorial on this effect.